Welcome to yoga. I'm going to just do a modified version of a yin-yang style, vinyasa flow. And I wanted to share just a minute with my daughter taught last night. And one of the nice things that she said was, yoga is a combination of effort, wise effort, and ease. And there was a great yogi that wrote a book about that. So I encourage you to listen to your body, push it to where it should be, and stop where you need to. So as we begin our practice, we're just going to settle into the ground, feeling your sits bones connected to the earth. Begin to shift gears and allow yourself to sink into the earth, making sure that your knees are connected somehow to the ground. And if that means taking a block and sticking them under your knees, please do that now. Feel your sacrum connected down as you begin to just settle and let go. Begin breathing through your nose into your belly. Exhaling through your throat, perhaps with an audible sigh. Again, inhale through your nose. Exhale through your throat. Just begin to notice any sensations in your body, any distractions, your body temperature. See if in this moment you can be an observer of what's happening rather than labeling or judging or trying to fix anything. Go ahead and gently open your eyes as you continue that inward gaze and yet seeing what's happening in the outside world. Take a breath as you reach and expand, reaching for the sky. Exhale as you drop any tension, stress, anything you're carrying down, connecting your chin to your chest. Let's do two more of those. Gather the energy, inhale. Exhale, audible breath. Sound of the ocean wave. Again, inhale up. Prayer as you exhale, coming to place them to your heart. Taking a moment to set your intention, what you would like for this time that we share together. And then reach your hands out to set a blessing to someone, maybe a lot of different people, in our world that so much needs it. Gather up the energy again, inhale, exhale, and gently tuck your belly in, navel to the spine. Give a hug as we begin our practice. Hands clasp your elbows, take a breath up, reach, just notice your shoulders, any tension, see if you can release, maybe let your gaze follow your arms. And matching your breath with that movement. And then reverse direction. You can just allow the sound of my voice rather than having to look at what I'm doing. See if you can just feel what feels good in your body. Maybe your neck makes little circles along with it. Last time, together. And then let's gently walk our hands on the ground, remembering taking a block if you need it. Feeling those hips open, try to sink your sits bones down, walking your way, and perhaps you can only get to a level with your back flat here. In that case, you might bring two blocks up, allow your head to rest, or continue all the way to where your body is telling you it needs today. the remembering that saying, that work between wise effort and ease. Feeling your back open up, your hips open up. And just hold it there for a few seconds. And breathe it out. Up on your fingertips, so you're tenting your fingers and you can feel that nice stretch right under your armpit. Walking your hands back as you reach your way to the left side. Reaching that hand away from you so you can feel the stretch right in your hip all the way down under your armpit, and perhaps you can let your head rest, maybe even kiss your knee. Thank yourself for being here today, taking the time out for you just to rejuvenate, refresh, and relax. You might even feel a little burning sensation with simply the fascia beginning to stretch. Walk your hands back to center and through to the other side. Great, that looks awesome. And breathe and drop. Noting each side is different and honoring the differences inside. Holding here for a couple more breaths. And then you can float your arms all the way up if your abs are completely tight, or you might walk your hands back. Hands reach up, reach behind you, fingertips towards me. Place those hands on the ground, reaching those hips up high. As you look to the sky, maybe even let your head drop all the way back for a bit of inversion. And right here, you feel your hip flexors open up, releasing. Breathing, strong body, strong mind, and shoulders holding you up. Slowly dropping back down. And switch your legs any way you like. Either here, you might open and then cross. So note just changing sides, what happens in your body. You might need a block again. And then let's simply just walk down for a second to get that hip a chance to open, because it's totally different from one side to the other. Let your breath be the guide to your body's opening. So gravity allows your body just to sink, and your breath moves you as your body gets happy in that particular spot, opens a little bit more. See if you can breathe right directly into the space that you're working on opening. One more breath together. And slowly reach up again. You can reach up through your core or walk your hands back through center. And now we're going to reach our hands back behind us and again open those hips. Adjusting how you might need to for those sides. Beautiful. Slowly come back down, bringing your legs out in front of you. Take that pillow out if you like. And let's just float our legs back and forth. Wide stance between your legs, and you can begin to look over your side And if you find a spot that feels really good, just stop there. You might keep moving or you might stop and breathe, opening your pecs, your chest, and then switching sides if you like, and hold. Come back to neutral, taking your right foot on the inside edge of your thigh. Leg is parallel. As we take that breath, reach up. Inhale, float your arms toward your feet. You may be walking your hands down. That's great. Stopping where you need and sink. Breathing and opening. Feel the backs of your hamstrings begin to soften. Maybe you feel tension. Be with that tension. Can you just allow the tension to be there? With the objective as nose to the knee, you're going to float this hand all the way up to the back of you as you reach for the ground, expand and open those hips. So you're just reaching and opening, lengthening, and feel the inner groin begin to soften. Head can relax down, it can look down, it can look up, wherever you need it to be. We'll simply come back down to that position. Grab that foot as you bend the knee behind you, opening up and stretching out that quad. If you want to come all the way down, feel free. All tension of the face is released. So just asking the muscle that needs the work to stretch. And in this case, our quad is releasing and relaxing. Our pecs are opening. If it were in your practice and you wanted to drop that foot to the ground and roll down, get a little bit more groin opener, also get a quad strip. You may float down if that's available, or just stay on your side and hold. Allow your hands to reach up to the sky. Let the chest be soft, your shoulders release. No tension. And then slowly floating back up. Grab a hold of that leg, extend it, and bring it over to pretzel. And if you like to extend that leg long, you may, and just cross it here. Or you may continue with that pretzel as we cross together. Take a breath, reach that arm up, and if it's available, that elbow reaches to the top of your thigh, and it's perfectly fine for it to reach the ground and press through. As you breathe in, you feel the vertebra expand. A little space creating more length. And as you exhale, you may be able to look behind you just a little bit more. Feel your hip drop and sink, inching your foot away from your sits bones. If it's sitting there as a little protective gauge, can you breathe into the groin? Breathe right into the sits bone and that glute, and see if you can let that muscle relax just a little bit more. Beautiful. Take a breath. Come back to center. Exhale as we move to the other side. This time, take your left foot into the inner groin. need a block at it. Take a breath up, inhale. Exhale, core is nice and strong, floating you over or walking your way to your foot. Hand can be at your calf, it can be at your feet, wherever it needs to be. Shoulders relax. Nice steady breaths, breathing into every cavity of your body, every cell, every muscle. Imagine your lymph system moving things out, toxins, all that beautiful oxygen filling up your body with health and vitality, strengthening your immune system. And floating your way up or walking your way up, lengthen that spine, drop that arm to the side as we reach up and open our groin, open our chest, grateful for this moment together. You may lift that leg, grab that foot, or you may sink in, bend that knee and grab your foot from here. See what your body needs today. Again, dropping down to your elbow is available, holding here. Keeping that inward gaze. As you are present, fully aware, fully conscious, this moment, embodied with yourself. Again, head can relax. If you would like, let this leg drop to the ground. Again, stay right where you are if you need to. You may even be wanting an inversion, and this is a great spot for an inversion, or you're just simply going to lay down. It's a little combination between a matsyasana, in a sense of opening that chest where that block or that pillow supports that upper back, that thoracic spine, and your head gets a little bit of a blood flow all the way into the top of the brain. All aspects of movement, fluid, draining, new neural pathways being created as we rest together. Slowly coming back up. And we'll float this leg back over. Straight leg or bent leg for that pretzel crossing, getting as erect as possible, nice, and at your own time, reaching up, and if you're already there, continue just hanging out in that space, opening and expanding your vertebra, exhale and twisting. So here is a good place to think about if you have any issues going on with any organs, send a little bathing energy of light and love, because we are physically moving into those organs to move intestines, spleen, liver, kidney. So just imagine flushing those with light. And then slowly unwinding and coming back together. Let's go ahead and roll onto our hands and knees. And we'll take a couple cat-cow. This way we're going to do it is take our hands a little wider today than your mat. And I want you to just reach all the way down. Find the spaces. Hips can move. You might even go back and you might even combine this with sort of an up dog. So you might even walk your hands forward. So see what it is you want. No pressure on the knees. Again, stopping when you find that place in your body that needs a little extra attention. So imagine that synovial fluid bathing each joint. And then switching directions when you're ready. Head can reach up on that up dog. Let it drop down when you reach back. Matching that breath with your movement. And then let's hold for up dog. Holding right here. Feel those hips open in the front, that inner groin. Press into the tops of your feet so that there's no pressure on your knees. Your shoulders calm down. Curling your toes under and moving into down dog. Plant your feet. Pull your belly in. Your gaze is at your navel. The energy is directly between your big toe and your baby toe. So feel your foot anchored in all directions. If you'd like to take a walk, go ahead and take a walk. And maybe you take yourself someplace that you haven't been for a while, that you miss, that you'd love to be at. And as though these baby feet, big feet, small feet, are moving on the earth for the very first time, can you just gently peel from the ball of your foot all the way through the center, and then your heel, and then your heel slowly lifts. If at any time you need to come down to child's pose, please do. If you need a break with your hands, shake them out. And then go ahead and reach that right leg up, square off those hips for a second. Just feel how that feels. Flex your feet, right? And then bend those knees. Open up that hip, let it drop, and go ahead and take some circles. Just breathing. If you'd like, and it's in your practice, you could continue to flip your dog. If you don't want that, don't do it. Reach back. Strong glute, strong opening then of the front of your body. Breathe here for a couple breaths. And then engage your core, pull your shoulders down, flip your dog back nice and gently. Walk that foot through your hands, noticing where you're going. If you'd like to drop your knee, go ahead and drop your knee. If you want to stay up in a crescent, please stay here. Crossing that elbow over as hands are in prayer. Looking over that elbow, testing your balance, squeezing your glutes. Coming back to center. If you're down, stay here and stretch out your leg, holding it right here. If you had come up, you simply step your foot in, hold it here, stretch out and hold. Together in down dog. Hold it here. Maybe rock the hips back and forth. Heels switch And notice what that does to your hips. Just add your waist. It should feel pretty good. And then let's take that other leg. Reach, raise it up. Squaring off that hip. Maybe you can see your toes, feel the gaze, and that leg long with that flexed foot. We'll bend that knee and open the hip. Some little gentle circles with the foot and the lower part of the leg. Nice. And if you want that flip, go ahead and take it or stay right there. Your body will naturally go if it wants to go. Squeeze the tush. Open up those hips. Slowly coming back. Core is tight. Flipping around. Looking through those hands and drawing your navel up as you place that foot in. Knee drops or knee stays into crescent. Either one. Making sure you're forward in that leg. Big breath up, hands to prayer, and begin to make that spinal twist. Elbow on the outside edge of your thigh. Pulling your navel in towards your back. As you inhale, you open, and as you exhale, you have a little more twist. Coming back to center, pause in that mantra. Your samasthitiya, thanking yourself for taking the time to take care of your body, your mind, and your spirit today. Hands drop to Mother Earth, bowing to that goddess within, all goddesses and gods everywhere, and stretching out. This is a great time to call in any spirit guides, anything that you connect with. It helps you get through the day. And then we're going to bring that leg back behind us, again for downward facing dog. Walking your hands to the feet this time. And if you want it already, you could be jumping your hands to your feet. See what you need. And then allow your head and your arms just to sink down. You might have a block here. You may be at your thighs. All are good. Shaking your head, yes, I will continue to hold myself gently with compassion as I do the same with the world. And no, I will not resort to that lower self, although sometimes I feel like it. And when I need to, I make amends, holding here. Slowly rolling up one vertebra at a time. Reaching to center. Holding it right here. Turning your right foot out. Reaching long for triangle. So your hips are going to walk away from you. Let the hand drop wherever it wants to go. And as it gets there, you might just see it wants to slide a little further down, being mindful of any pops or any openings or any places you need to stop. Inch by inch, every day is a new day. And we listen in a new way. Might we remember to drop what needs to be dropped and open for new blessings to come in. Head can relax. couple more breaths. Feel as though you have a string, a bird, whatever visual that reaches you to the sky, pulling on that middle finger, coming up. And then let's just move into warrior one. Holding right here, Virabhadrasana one. Warriors at heart. What do you need to cultivate inside to be that warrior for you today? You might walk your foot forward a little bit more, making sure that knee and ankle are in alignment. And then from here, hands come to prayer. And you might think about just stepping that back foot in a little bit and floating up for warrior three. Strong like warrior, challenging your balance, feeling your wings growing. Your breath is breathing you with all that going on. Play with whatever hand position you might want. Reaching in front, to the side, even to the back. And then slowly coming down. And peeling off for warrior two. Square off the hips, your shoulders. Good. And then look over your middle finger of the other side. Feel the energy expanding from your shoulders out through your fingertips, out to the world, holding hands in harmony, no matter what's going on. Let your arms circle. Head can come back to neutral. It can also go back to the other side. Or you may feel like you want to take some little head circles. Whatever you need to do. Breathing here. Floating this hand down your long leg. Knee bends for peaceful warrior. Reach back. Feel as though on your exhale you are bathing each chakra in light, love, connection. So you're opening to receive, dropping that arm to your thigh, to the ground, wherever it wants to be, through a bind and hold. Breathing, strong power, supple, flexible body. Taking this arm down now to reach the ground, turning this toe out, and sink. Wherever that sink is for you, you might even like to pull your yoga mat up to protect your knee, dropping down and holding, and breathing. Coming all the way back up, curling that toe under, floating your body back through center as we move that right toe in, that left toe out, heels fairly directly through the middle of that arch, unless you need a little more balance and widen out. And now we'll begin to reach to that side, lengthen out the hip. Hip comes away, feel the inner groin. Allow that arm to drop wherever it will. breathing and feeling your own heartbeat, your own breath that sustains you, connecting in to that ground, that root chakra. Arm can do a mirage of whatever it feels like. Maybe you need to open your shoulder, you could rest it on your back, or you could do little circles with your arms, challenging your balance. Just see. Again, it's a gentle hold, so trying not to grip. Beautiful, slowly, with a little help from the universe, float yourself up as it pulls you up. Nice, moving into that warrior two. Warrior one, sorry. Holding here, hips are square. Generally would help if I did one, two, and three, but I kind of mix them up as the day feels. Hands are going to come to prayer. Sink in, find your drishti, your point of focus, your balance. Reaching up off that toe. Perhaps your toe's right there, stay into the earth, that's fine. And coming into this holding position. Breathing energy out through that foot. Hands might move to the side. Feel your rhomboids supporting you, floating like a bird, free as a bird. Imagine being that bird. Maybe the arms come forward. A little bit more balance here is required. Hands could float back, slowly dropping that foot to the ground, peeling off four. Warrior two, sinking down, connecting in. How can you bring your practice to your day to day? What do you need to do? Maybe it's just to breathe. Maybe it's to take a break from your work. Force yourself to get up. Do that. Set the timer if you need to. Gaze over your back arm. Let your arms circle around. Head moves through center. For a breath, exhale over to the other side. This time, fingertips back. So baby finger is reaching, so you get a nice stretch all the way down that bicep. Hard. And then slowly floating back. You need to sink back, bring your foot back a little bit, go ahead. Floating back, bend that front knee. Straighten out that back leg. Feel the stretch in your waist. Inhale. Exhale as we float down. Again, you can see color perhaps when you go to each chakra. Knee floats, toe, hand comes down, holding it right here. No pressure here. Hand could even drop to the ground as the arm reaches up to your thigh behind you, staying up or binding. If you're binding, notice if your shoulder wants to float forward. Think about bringing it open, open chest. Shoulders and posture. Stay open to keep you erect with good posture through the day. Head can float down though. Deep breath, inhaling and exhaling. And then we're going to turn that body like a cartwheel down, turning that foot out, dropping that knee. Coming down to wherever you can on this side. So notice You may not be able to get down as far on one side or the other. Use your blocks. Letting your head drop. Shoulders are relaxed. It can be withholding and supporting. This time we're going to come together and sneak into pigeon. It's one of the best hip openers I know, and we've done some versions of that today. You can also be on your back with your foot crossed over your thigh if you prefer that, and then relax your head down into the ground. Maybe you most people can't. A block under your hip can be nice and useful. And sometimes coming up and just stretching that low back for that low cobra or high cobra, low down on your forearms, high on your hands. If you wiggle back and forth, you may actually get your glute to release a little bit. And then as your glute releases, and I like to use my fist in my hands because all connecting points start in the toes and the feet, all the way up to the top of your vertebrae and your neck and shoulders. So then I can maybe play and inch my way up, sinking, taking what I get here and holding. Breathing and relaxing. See if you can keep softening on each one of those moves. Back up, bringing that leg back as you bring your opposite leg forward for pigeon on this side. Lengthen out the spine, perhaps rocking back and forth. Find your way at your most optimum angle. And simply dropping back down. Hands can reach directly out in front of you. Remember, if you get a cramp in your foot, take your toes and flex them on the ground, press them in, and then release them when you'd like. Shoulders are relaxed, throat is relaxed. Nice big breaths. Perhaps coming to that up dog, that little cobra on your forearms, whichever, and then rocking back, bringing that foot out a little bit more. And remember that fist on this side if you want. Through your day, keep a little ball, something you can roll your feet on, and you'll be amazed what that will do with your back, that will do with your neck pain. And then slowly coming back down again. See if you find a little bit more opening this time. Breathe. Slowly coming to your back. We're going to move into bridge. Just fingertips touch the backs of your feet. Hips or knees and ankles are hip width apart. Let your head relax. Maybe shake it back and forth. Deep breath, inhale. Scoop your belly. As you exhale, sacrum rolls and reaches all the way up to the sky. Shoulders could reach under, clasping your hands if you wanted. A nice bicep chest opening stretch. Holding it right there. Feel your throat open, relaxing. Your eyes can soften and relax. Slowly taking your hands out, reaching up, one hand to heart, one hand to belly. Connecting those neural pathways, the same as that are in our mind. Breathing into that for a second. Emptying out fear, doubt, concern, and breathing in what you want. Love, joy, connection, relaxation, peace. If it's in your practice for our last wheel, you can take wheel. Hands can come to the side. Your feet will open up a little bit. You'll scoop your pelvis under. Really engage your triceps. And you'll see from me, and I will stay just hovering gently right here for as long as you have it in your practice. No pressure on your head. Hold it up. I'm going to come down. When you're ready, you come down together with me. As we end together, if you're ready to end, knees come into your chest for a gentle hug. Some rolls back and forth. If you feel you need a little more spinal twist, you could take your legs to one side and hold and breathe. Inhaling and exhaling. Extending that bottom leg if you want a little deeper stretch. Inhaling and exhaling. One more breath in. Exhale, pull your navel in and allow your body to move those legs up. Hands are reaching towards the sky. Take it to the other side as your head looks over the other hand. Holding it here. Let your inner groin go. There's a tendency to grip. If you can just feel your spine open. Extend that bottom leg if you're feeling called. One more breath together. And on that exhale, belly comes in, reach. Go ahead and grab wherever you can for happy baby. Maybe the inside or outside edge. Feel your sacrum flattening out. Maybe some rocks. And from here, hanging out here, if you wanted to straighten your legs, you could play with that. And if they gently wanted to just come overhead, you could play with that too for halasana. They might not touch the ground, or maybe they decide to. Letting your body see what it wants, what it needs. Ask for what you want, you take what you get. Grateful for whatever that is. Feel your back release here. Hands can be on your back for support, or they can lengthen as you lengthen your shoulders away, making more room in your throat. Perhaps you take your legs up for an inversion for shoulder stand. Trying as much as possible to get those hips and the feet lined up together. And then slowly dropping those knees to your forehead. May you continue to have vision of light, love, and hope. And slowly, one vertebra at a time, moving to a shavasana of your choice. Begin allowing your feet to drop down to the earth. Legs could go straight out, toes dropping away from you, hands rising to meet the sky. Feel the connection of the universe with you in the middle, a very integral piece of the puzzle. Begin to settle into your mat. Noticing today, as we started the practice, here while we're finishing, what you may have noticed. Maybe a few shifts in your body. And now in your own mind's eye, scanning your body for a minute, from the very top of your head, noticing any tension in your eyes, your forehead, your temples, begin to soften and relax. Feeling the softness of your eyes fluttering perhaps back and forth, relaxing, releasing, letting go of any images, any thoughts of how you think you should be, embracing all imperfections or perfections in the way that you might see them. Feel the skin on your face come away from the bone. As you do that, your jaw releases, making room for the capsules in your joints to release tension. Your jaw moves easily, softly. Feeling from the backs of your ears down your traps, your deltoids. Noticing any tension as it either arises or you find spaces. And can you breathe a little deeper into those spaces and let them go? Merge with the earth. Become Buttarasana, where you are one with the ground. The muscles sink in a little deeper as you continue down through your thoracic spine, wrapping around your rib cage. Maybe even in your mind, you can see the intercostals, the cartilage between the ribs, expanding and relaxing, creating space and opening. And as you do that, your muscles begin to relax deeper, healed, replenished, and rejuvenated. Feeling your breath expand a little deeper into your belly, noticing what's there. Perhaps in that svadhisthana where our organs are, you might even notice some sensations, perhaps little butterflies, perhaps tension. It's okay. Can you hold yourself in that space of acceptance that this too shall pass? Can you continue down to your pelvis, your reproductive organs? Just feeling everything soften, relaxing, letting go. Feel your hips release, your buttocks release. All the way down, the hamstrings are soft. Noticing where your feet hit the ground. Perhaps there's a little more on one side than the other. One foot might turn out a little further than the other. Simply noticing. Nothing to do to change or fix. A silent witness to your body. And then going to the very bottoms of your feet and then imagining all the way around your toes, the tops of your feet, your shins, your inner groin. Take a deep breath and I want you to squeeze every muscle. Exhale and relax even deeper. Taking 30 seconds of silence in your own happy spot. Go there now. And then when you're ready, slowly bringing your awareness back to your body. Begin some gentle movement in your hands, your feet, inviting a stretch in. Whatever feels is needed, begin to do that now. Feeling with a grateful heart what you did for yourself today, giving yourself this time and this space of self-care. As you roll to the side in that fetal position, relaxing there for just a second. Remember this feeling of connection with yourself, this openness, this stretch. And remember to stop in your day and go here to that place of quiet, where peace resides, this full embodied presence. Slowly begin to make your way up to a seated position, getting whatever props you need. To close our practice together. Hands come to our head to continue right thought to our lips to speak kindness and to open to compassion first for ourselves and then to others. Thank you for sharing practice together. Have a beautiful day, and I'll look forward to seeing you soon. Namaste.